Welcome to Marie Stopes Kenya, helping you realize your reproductive health options. Every year, over 358,000 women die and many more suffer pregnancy-related complications. If a woman chooses to have a child, she should have the right to quality and affordable care and support.
Imagine how much easier managing your practice will be if your practice management software was web-based. There will be no software to install or configure, no time-consuming server setup or maintenance, and no recurring IT costs. You will be able to access and manage your practice's information from any device, PC, Mac, or mobile device from anywhere with an internet connection.
With whom? What does this guy look like? How does he think? How does he walk? Maybe he's in this room. I don't know.
It's so risky. Oh my God, the camera's on the whole time. So, an old boy. That's not good.
It began back in the 80s. on a septic tank with a mop. And this is transforming society through mentorship.
There are no words to describe this feeling. Love Yourself Selfie was a dream, and in this moment, it became a reality. Like any good vision, there is something that sparks it, and for me, it was her.
I chose Love Yourself Selfie because I really wanted to find a way to bring the concept of a selfie from the US here to Kenya. And while we truly use it to be really, you know, into ourselves, to be self-absorbed, but I truly felt like kids here could appreciate it in a way that truly meant to love yourself.
Hospital. A few years ago, while I was studying freshman internship, I got an injury, a needle stick injury that was contaminated with HIV, two of them in the space of a month. I underwent treatment and I was okay. A few months later, I had a child who was in bad condition, who was also HIV positive, and who needed blood very urgently. There was no blood in the entire coastal region, and so the only way to save this child was to donate my own blood. A sample of my blood was taken to Nairobi Blood Bank. Here it was tested, and a few months later I was given the results that I was HIV positive. When the results came back, I was very, very distraught. I didn't know where to go, who to tell. I was worried that I could not continue my life the way I had planned it. I didn't know whether I could ever get married. It was a very difficult time. I spent the next few months in and out of counseling and in and out of private labs so that I could confirm my results, only to find out that the results were negative. I'm telling you my story today because I want you to know the problems that doctors go through in terms of payment for their own services that they give, and the fact that we did not have blood in our entire referral hospital.